Well, it looks like air coolers might be a regular thing here on the channel, if we find cool stuff, obviously. But then again, it didn't really go out that well for Corsair's A500 that we checked out recently. But the subject for today's video actually comes from your suggestions in that video. It is none other than the Scythe Fuma 2 air cooler. I actually have to make sure that I don't cut myself because this thing is ridiculously sharp. Like, I'm actually very afraid of holding it like right now because it's pretty sure I'm going to end up with a lot of cuts after this video. Get it? Cuts. Editing a video. Cuts. That was a bad joke. Alright, so what makes the Fuma 2 special? Well, its focus is on silence and compatibility, but it's also supposed to have some wicked performance due to its pretty unique fan setup. And the best part is that it costs $60, which is a lot less than a lot of the other coolers that we've tested. I'm pretty excited about this one since it would be popular to have an alternative to some of the most popular heatsinks out there in the market. So I guess the only way to find out is to put the Fuma 2 up against our super hot running test system and see what it performs like. But first, a quick message from our sponsor.
The new Corsair K95 Platinum RGB XT lets you program the 6 macro keys on the left to work beautifully with Stream Deck for endless customization while you stream or game, plus PBT keycaps, a comfy wrist rest, and a quality K95 body. Check it out below.
Alright, so usually I'd skip over what's inside the box, but Scythe actually includes a full list of goodies. So there's a nicely braided fan splitter cable, a magnetic screwdriver, and a tube of thermal compound with enough for at least 3 applications. There are also 3 fan brackets. So let me explain why this is so important. Out of the box, Scythe includes one thin 15mm fan and one that's a standard 25mm. The slimmer one is there to make sure that there are no issues with memory compatibility, but if your system has enough clearance, you can use the extra bracket to replace it with a higher performance one. Or you could just keep the stock fans and add a third to really maximize performance. But there's more to this fan setup than what you might think. Even though they both move air in the same direction, the front fan spins in a counterclockwise direction while the middle one runs clockwise. According to Scythe, this actually increases static pressure and allows the two fans to operate at a maximum of 1200 RPMs to perform more like they're going at much higher speeds, and I can't wait to put that claim to the test. So onto the heatsink itself, and it's a pretty straightforward dual tower design with aluminum fin arrays that are capped with a plain black metal. There's also 6 heat pipes, which happens to be 2 more than Corsair uses on their $100 A500 cooler. Yes, I'm still ranting about that thing. Anyways, another nice thing to see here is a flat base that's machined to pretty high standards. Nope, there's no cheaply designed heat pipe direct touch base here, which is awesome. Once the fans are installed, I have to give compliments to Scythe. I'm loving these stealth looks they have going on over here. Don't worry, we'll ruin it with Noctua fans a bit later. Speaking of Noctua, the Fuma 2's size is pretty much the same as the NHU12A, though it's a bit wider. That also makes it a lot more compact than the NHD12. As for the installation process, well, I think it's one of the best around because I actually prefer it over anything from Noctua, Be Quiet, or nearly anyone else. I won't go through every installation here since that would take forever, but let's just say that the only difference between platforms is that there is a backplate that's provided for Intel 775, 1150 series, and 1366 sockets, whereas on AMD systems, you'll need to reuse your motherboard's backplate. Aside from that, Scythe provides a system of standoffs and a crossbar type mounting plates that's compatible with every platform. Basically, after these standoffs are installed, you just screw down the mounting bar, and up to this point, it's very similar to Noctua's design. But when it comes to installing the cooler, there's one major difference that makes this thing so much easier. Instead of there being threaded rods on the crossbars, there's a hole with angled guides, and this helps the heatsink's pre-installed screws slide right into position without any hassle. This is a brilliant, easy system, and I love it since you can easily get the best possible mount. I also have to give a ton of credit to Scythe for focusing on compatibility, and it's pretty obvious that they did some serious homework to make sure that the Fuma 2 worked in almost every condition. But I do have to mention that this cooler is meant to be only mounted in a left and right direction and not up and down. On a platform like Intel's 2066 with quad channel memory, the elevated heatsink allows it to clear even super tall memory. Meanwhile, the slim fan means every memory slot can be populated, but you need to be aware that the tolerances are super tight. I noticed that the lower fins do make contact. Something else to note is the ASRock X299CLX that I used here has a ridiculously tall VRM heatsink, and even that wasn't a problem, The only slight issue shows up if you want to mount a third fan on a system that has high memory or V-arm heatsinks, since it'll need to be pushed upwards. Moving on to AM4, and there's no problem here either, since Scythe swept the Fuma 2 heat pipes forward to make sure that the main fins are far away from the memory slots, but don't expect to install a full-size second fan if your memory slots are fully populated, because there's just not enough space. Okay, so now on to performance, but before I get into that, I do want to quickly go over a few things. First up, it is very important to note that the two fans on the Fuma 2 are set to operate at a maximum of 1200 RPMs, which is a lot slower than anything else we've tested here. The second thing is that our testing methodology, along with all the coolers used in this video, are linked down below. So starting things off with the stock speed testing on the 10980XC, and it looks like the Fuma 2 is able to keep up with some of the best coolers available. Now, it's important to take note that this CPU is running around 165 watt TDP, which happens to be the worst case scenario for many current Intel and AMD CPUs. So this proves that Scythe's $60 heatsink can effectively cool literally any processor currently available. But the amazing thing is that it competes with the Noctua D15 and it beats the U12A in terms of acoustics. Even with the fans operating at 1000 RPMs, it's really, really competitive with heatsinks that cost quite a bit more. But pay special attention to the Noctua U14S, since it costs only a few bucks more than the Fuma 2. At 1000 RPMs, Scythe's counter-rotation fan design seems to be making a pretty big difference, since this happens to be one of the quietest CPU coolers that we've come across. Now this part is pretty cool, guys. The Fuma 2 hits about 58 degrees Celsius, which is one of the lowest temperatures, but its fan speeds are a good 300 RPMs lower than the D15 and the U14S. And guess what that leads into? That's right, it just kills everything else in noise testing by a long shot. I can't highlight this enough, guys. When it comes to performance versus noise, the Fuma 2 is literally in a world of its own. But now it's time for overclock testing, and the 10980XC running along at 4.5 GHz gets lava hot. Well, on the positive side, Scythe was able to design this cooler well enough that it didn't cause CPU throttling due to high temperatures, but 97 degrees Celsius is still pretty high. And the decibel results proved that it was running at full fan speed at the test's end, but honestly, it's just so damn quiet. At a constant 1000 RPM, it still technically passes, and that's impressive, like really impressive. Finally, at 100% fan speed, the Fuma 2 actually manages to beat the U14S, and it runs pretty close to the U12A. Now remember, it's pulling these numbers at much lower noise levels, and not only that, it only costs $60, guys. So I think it's safe to say that Scythe has designed a really, really good air cooler for $60. But I'm not willing to leave this review here without some more testing with different fan configs. So let's start things off with Noctua's two NF812s. This is really amazing, and it proves that Scythe closely designed their heatsink and fans in parallel. At stock settings and a constant 1000 RPM, the Fuma 2's regular setup actually wins. At full speed, the dual Noctua setup pulls ahead, but remember, two of those Noctuas will be much, much louder than Scythe's stock fans, and they cost just as much as a brand new Fuma 2. And yeah, I really don't think spending all that money on upgraded fans really benefits this cooler. But I didn't want to stop there, because Scythe does include an extra set of fan brackets, so I decided to mount a third fan right over here, one that doesn't stick out like a sore thumb. Well, this is the Cooler Master SF120M, and in our testing, it can easily compete against the NF812 without ruining the Fuma 2's stealthy good looks. For a $30 investment, the stock temperature results are pretty impressive, with the triple fan setup hitting temperature levels that are getting closer to 280mm AIO levels. In the overclock testing, running the three fans at 1200 RPM, the temperature equals the dual Noctua config, while noise levels were a lot lower. Well, I guess it's time to wrap this up, and I want to level with you guys here. The Fuma 2 from Scythe impressed the heck out of me. It's the lowest price cooler in our charts, and it competed really well against the alternatives that cost $40 more. So if you're running a more basic system than us with the 10980XC, say for instance you're running a 9900K or AMD's 3950X, this should be our go-to cooler, and you're actually better off spending the extra $40 on perhaps a better memory kit, or a better GPU, or something else. Sure, it couldn't hit extreme cooling levels with the overclocked, fire-breathing 10980XC, but that was expected since Scythe designed it for silence before performance. And did it accomplish that? Yeah, it did. It certainly did. So I'm going to do something that I haven't done in a really long time and actually give the Scythe Fuma 2, the hardwarecanucks, damn good value award. So, were you impressed with the Scythe Fuma 2? In fact, what do you think of that name Scythe? I'm actually really in love with that because there's something so stealthy about that. Also, I'm glad that I didn't cut my fingers, but anyways, that's it for me, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to check out some relevant content over here. Subscribe, hit that notification bell, and I'll talk to you guys in the next one. Scythe. Like, who comes up with these names? Like, I wish I was part of this name-making process, because it's just so cool. Maybe I should name my pet Scythe.